evening, brothers and sisters. Welcome to St. Dominic's Catholic Church. We thank you for your cooperation and remind you to strictly adhere to all sanitizing, mask wearing, and social distancing protocols for the times. As for our president, we are adhering to the 50% capacity limit. We kindly request volunteers to each assist in the sanitizing of the church after the mass. This weekend is the 6th Sunday in ordinary time, and the theme of the day is the two words for the attitudes. The intentions for this mass are for the souls of Eva and Sarah Simon and Maria Vera, Alexander Pfeiffer, and all the souls in purgatory. For celebrating this evening, Father Graham, please stand for the invitation. so are we good, not so. For they like the no child shall be driven away by the wind. For the Lord knows the way of the just, but the way of the wicked will perish. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brethren, if Christ is preached as raised from the dead, how can some of you say that there is no resurrection of the dead? For if the dead are not raised, then Christ has not been raised. If Christ has not been raised, your faith is futile, and you are still in your sins. Then those who have fallen asleep in Christ have perished. If for this life only we have lived in Christ, we are all of all men most to be put to death. But in Christ, in fact, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. The word of the Lord.
There was a man who became very prosperous, and this is what he said: I have been poor, and I have been rich. Rich is better. Most of us would agree with him. We seek possessions, comfort, and pleasure. We shun poverty, hunger, and sorrow. We reflect the popular culture. But then we hear this very puzzling gospel: blessed are the poor, blessed are the hungry, blessed are the sorrowing. Woe to the rich, woe to the comfortable, woe to the satisfied. This gospel does not resonate with modern culture. How does a sincere Christian reconcile this? Today's gospel is Luke's version of the eight Beatitudes. The more popular version of the Beatitudes is from Matthew's gospel. I think Matthew's gospel is highlighted for you over there. That's the more popular version, so I'm not surprised that one got put up. We like that. Blessed are the peacemakers, the poor, the persecuted. Luke's Beatitudes are four blessings and four warnings. The deprived are blessed, the prosperous are warned. Each gospel has its own theme. Matthew is concerned with the fulfillment of God's prophecies. Luke offers comfort, healing, and forgiveness. Luke's gospel comforts the afflicted and afflicts the comfortable. That is especially true of Luke's version of the Beatitudes. Jesus blesses the poor, the hungry, the weeping. He rebukes the rich, the satisfied, and the esteemed. Christ comforts the afflicted and afflicts the comfortable. Yet many wonder, how are the poor blessed? They seem to be distressed. Why are the rich in danger? They appear to be doing just fine. This gospel does not mean that the poor have a free ticket to heaven, and it does not mean that the rich are on the highway to hell. Our great saints include the rich and the poor alike, the successful and the struggling. The poor are blessed in that God is with them in the pursuit of justice. The rich are in danger if their wealth estranges them from God. The poor and the hungry realize their dependence on God in a way that the rich and comfortable seldom do. It is not their hardship in and of itself that is blessed, but only when it better disposes them to trust in God. The rich and the comfortable are seldom aware of such a need for God. For example, people in the third world struggle for the basics of life every day. They live in total dependence on God. We middle-class South Africans have credit cards, medical cards, ATMs, and convenience stores. We are proud to be self-sufficient. We seldom feel the need for God. Yet there is one area of our lives where we do know our dependence on God, and that is in illness. In serious illness, we realize our total dependence on God. Just as the poor know that need every day in every facet of their life. Perhaps that is why, as people age and their health ebbs, their faith often blossoms. We can also be poor in our personal relationships and our inner struggles. Such trials can be a hidden blessing if, through them, we come to know better our dependence on God. Woe to you rich reminds the fortunate of their obligation to be God's agents in bringing justice to the poor, the hungry, and the outcast. The danger of wealth is that it easily isolates one from the needy and blinds one to the demands of justice. Once upon a time, a newly married couple was struggling with their finances. The young husband said, "I know we are not doing well now, but I'm going to work hard and be successful, and someday we will be rich." His young bride said, "We are already rich. Maybe someday we will have money." That man said, "I have been poor and I have been rich. Rich is better." Saint Paul wrote, "I know what it is to have little, and I know what it is to have plenty. I have learned to be content with whatever I have, for I can do all things through Him who strengthens me."
Thank you.
words of the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Rejoice and leap for joy, for surely your reward is great in heaven. The good news of Jesus Christ fills us with joy, and as children of our living God, we turn to the Lord in prayer.
So, the response is, Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
So, trust in God. God's word declares, listen, those who trust in the Lord, may we be people who trust in the Lord and in God, bearing fruit for God by lives of integrity. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For renewed faith in the risen Christ. Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruit of those who have fallen asleep. May we be renewed in our faith in the risen Christ, and live as people of hope, trusting in God's promise of eternal life. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For a deep commitment to the way of Jesus. The Beatitudes of Jesus teach us what is of value in life. May we be more and more convinced of his teaching and committed to live by his word. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For a desire to live as God commands. May we be moved by the teaching of Jesus to live as his disciples in the world, professing our faith in God's purposes by following the Beatitudes of Jesus in all that we do. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Yeah. may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
He gave to his disciples.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you allow us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. And we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. We know the Lord your Church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Lucy our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph of Stars, with the Blessed Apostles, the Saint Dominic, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Oh, said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on ourselves, but on the faithful church, and let us be granted peace and unity in accordance with your word, to live and reign forever and ever. Amen." The peace of the Lord be with you all. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge of